Hi everyone and welcome to this new video of the Floss Marketing School. Today we are going to see how you can play with data visualization and Matomo analytics. So most of you probably know software such as Google Data Studio, Microsoft BI and Tableau software, but the main issue with those is that they are sending data to either Amazon, either Microsoft or either Google. So let's see how we can change that out and let's see how we can send some Matomo data within the data visualization software such as LibreOffice Calc, and let's see how we can play with those data. Okay, so here we are in LibreOffice Calc, as you can see, and what we would like to do is to insert some data within it coming from Matomo and to be able to play with visualization possibilities such as a pie chart. So the first thing that you need to have is of course some data feeds. So the data feeds, you are getting it straight away from Matomo Analytics thanks to the API. So over here, every time that you are choosing one of those data feeds, so in our case we're going to use the TSV Excel, if you click on show export URL, you will get the URL of this data feed. So of course you can technically use the database of Matomo, which is a MySQL database. Unfortunately, it's not, let's say, the real data that you will get. It will be only the raw data. And the problem with the raw data is that they will need actually an additional work in order to get the data that you can see from those reports here. So if you would like to get the same data as you can see within the regular report of Matomo Analytics, you need to get through the API. Okay, and this is the method that we're gonna see right now. So you go for the TSV Excel, you click here on show export URL, and you get your URL of the data feed. So of course, don't disclose this URL to anyone because you have your token here. And you should not disclose this token here. It's a bit exceptional. It's the anonymous token, so we don't risk anything. And this is public data that we are getting here. But for your real website, you do not disclose this data. Okay, so it means actually the one who are going to have an access to your Calc spreadsheet should be only people that you trust. Okay, and then, and this is the thing that I didn't know, in Calc, actually, you have a feature in order to import some external file, and this is exactly what we are doing up here, right? If I just click on this given cell, as you can see here, I have the given request that I want to call. So in my case, this request is exactly the same as I just passed. So I'm just gonna paste it back over here, and here, as you can see, you have all the parameters of Matomo, which are composed of the date that you would like, the date range that you would like to query, the format that you would like to get. And this additional part corresponds to the cell that you're going to get out of this TSV file. Okay, so in our case here, we are interested in getting the A1 cell, which corresponds in our case to the label one, right? So if I go, for example, here in HTML mode and if I click on export, I will get this one. Okay, and if I ask for A2, I will get this one, and so on and so forth. So if I go back now on my calc file and that I just press enter, as you can see, it's taking a bit of time because what is happening right now is that Calc is making the request to Matomo, and now I can just go this way, and I can go as well this way, and it's gonna automatically update all the data, right? All that you can see here. And as you can see, my pie chart change, and here I can really use, in fact, all the strengths of my spreadsheet software. So I can either go for, yeah, I can go for column stuff, that's nice. Okay, and you can really change the way that the data is displayed, and of course then you can add your comment over here. Okay, we are doing great, we are doing great on desktop this month. Okay, desktop this month. Okay, and so on and so forth. So that's great, because after you can disclose, of course, this spreadsheet, and you can, of course, if you are using software such as Nextcloud, you can even make it public. So it's kind of cool because you can collaborate with your colleagues. And in order to update those data, because that's the biggest and most important point here, you need actually to change. So it's a bit techy. You need to change the value up here, right? So if you just say the 3rd of May, and you're going to change it to the 16th of May, and you press enter, you're going to see that it's going to take some time because, of course, Once more, Calc need to make the request to Matomo, and that's it. Okay, so you need all the time to make this manual stuff work in order to get your data. Okay, so of course it's a bit of work, but that's necessary here. And as you can see, the data have been updated, and it's pretty cool because I can create everything that I want. So I can keep all of that out and without sending any data to Google, Amazon, neither Microsoft. And that's it for today. So I really hope that you enjoyed this video. Please feel free to try actually this given feature of LibreOffice Calc, which is equal and then simple quote, then the URL that you would like to request, then simple quote, then hash, and then you indicate what is the cell that you would like to request and to display within your spreadsheet. Once more, I really hope that you enjoyed this video. Please do not hesitate to share it, to create your own video as well, and to share your knowledge about open source solutions. Thanks for watching.